People sitting in front of me that had a spirit of unforgiveness. So I said, Lord, are you sure? Am I not supposed to be teaching on you know, this stuff here, Lord? And, anyways, I tested the waters a moment, and sure enough, that was the God that spoke to me. God, I want to just tell you how much we love you today. I want to give you all our praises and enter in your gates as we come here with thanksgiving in our hearts. Come into your court with praise for the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that washes us clean from all unrighteousness. For your Holy Spirit which comes and guides us and comforts us, for your gospel that you've given us, your kingdom. I want to thank you for food and clothing, for this building, the meeting, for our finances, our families, our homes, our animals. Praise you, Father God. Thank you for healing and miracles and deliverance, your protection. We're such a blessed people. We just want to give you all the praise, Father God. You're Lord of glory, the King of kings, and we just stand before you in awe this morning. Oh, we worship you, Lord. Guide us here. What you want to do, Lord. Amen. You know, I think there's a lot of people that think that Papa God isn't like a real person. But he is. He's not just some kind of energy force up there. In fact, there's some really amazing accounts of some people that were gone longer than I was. And he brought back, and there's a little girl I heard about, and she got into the room, and there's no other way you would know this. She's 4 years old, and she said, she described the creature with all the faces and eyes and the long legs that kept going, and she was scared. And Papa God said, come. And she jumped on his lap, and then she felt safe. What a better place to be, eh?
Sorry.
And she said, Jesus looked just like Papa God. They're almost identical. And they have hair like lightning. I was doing a service, and this was before I got healed, and I had a lady come up to me afterwards, and she said, I saw angels standing with you, and I didn't know what to do with that. So I went, cool. And I went to the other side of the sanctuary, and I was talking with one of the pastors, and these little girls came up to me, tugged on my coat, and they said, we saw angels with you. And so this time I thought, I should ask questions. So. Well, what did they look like? Well, they were big and shiny like lightning. I find that, let's give you a testimony. There was a woman that contacted me that had gestational diabetes. And she was starting to tell me, you know, her problems with the pregnancy and all that was going on. I said, you got a broken heart. Now, I'm not always operating in the gifts of knowledge, because a lot of times is so predictable to me now. I mean, words of knowledge, I mean, that happens to me, because sometimes I know stuff that I couldn't possibly know. But I said, you've got a broken heart, and you probably got a broken relationship with your father. And there's dead silence on the phone. She said, she was Oriental. Her father gave her away because she was a girl. You talk about abandonment issues. You know, when a father, you know, God is the man responsible, and when a father isn't a good father to his children and a good husband to his wives, all manner of evil comes in. Okay? So guys, you're being held responsible today. So I said to her, you know, I ministered on the phone for a long time, and I taught her from the Word. And then I said, go get your husband. And I said, put me on speakerphone. They're in another state. I have, like, this happening a lot these days, you know, people from Australia phone up and get healed. God heals them over the phone. The only thing I haven't figured out how to do is water baptize somebody over the phone. But I'm working on it. So I said, get your husband. I said, here.